Outback 31 RQS here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. This is a rear quad slide, RQS, get it? Roughly 31 foot box, get it? 31 RQS, see, it's starting to make sense already. She weighs 7290. I've looked at too many numbers today. Weighs 7,290 pounds, so right in that half ton towable market. Big super slide, rear quad bunk, awesome family camper. It is not quite as big as it's made to look to be. They designed this with what looks to be just a huge chunk of a body. But if you look real close, it's a little bit of a visual aesthetic trick. You see this line right here? That's where the floor stops. This is just skirting. They make it look extra big, but it does have some benefits because they're able to offer like an extra little bucket of storage down here. And check out this gigantic front pass-through storage. It's absolutely huge. Gentlemen, when you get in trouble with your wives, you could sleep down here, and frankly, you could be doing worse. It's not all that bad. Front decals, like most of the decals on the trailer, actually have been faded. This is what, like an 06 or something like that? So it's seen some time, you know, but it's here. I don't see where it's leaked. That's the biggest thing. Everything appears to be in good working order. It's just been stored outside, like most campers. A little bit of decal fade has happened. That's actually something for a period Keystone was known for. In today's market, they've actually corrected that because they weren't real happy with how their decals looked over time. They've actually gone to a much thicker, heavier decal today, but that has nothing to do with this trailer. Anyway, so this is a Sydney edition, which was the bigger series of Outbacks way back when. And you've got another big pass-through storage over here. Well, actually, let's go look at that. All the windows open for breeze, by the way. You've got excellent airflow. Spare tire in the back doesn't really, I don't see where it's really touched the ground. Looks pretty darn good. Yeah, you know what? Maybe a little bit of weathering on here. So keep in mind, I go out of my way to show you guys the real aspects of the trailer, the real truth inside and out. I don't gloss anything over. I don't hide stuff. I call it like I see it and I tell it as it is so that you can be confident working with our dealership. Now, this is sweet. So this storage goes all the way below the rear bunks. It starts up here and it wraps around and goes all the way over and through and wraps around that side too. Huge pass-through storage. One of the largest I've really ever seen in a travel trailer. And because they're going down below the floor level and actually using up part of the skirt space, you get this extra big bucket. This right here, you're just begging to set in some coolers and stuff like that and have it nice and tucked away, but not directly baking in the sun. So, you know, it's gonna be a little warm in that compartment, but it won't be cooking right in the sun, so your drinks are gonna stay cooler longer. And if you do, if you like the big fancy modern outside kitchens, thank Keystone. They're the ones that kinda pioneered the concept with these little mini outdoor kitchenettes. This was just a calling card to Outback for just ages. They weren't the only ones to do it, but they were the ones that did it the most in mainstream. And you know, you've got your cooktop, your little sink outside, and it's nice. It's a nice thing to have, and it's directly under this pretty sizable patio awning, you know. Stepping inside here, we got a nice easy triple step. I noticed they put like a nice reinforcement board on the floor right here. A couple advantages this gives us. First of all, being carpeted, it gives you a place to wipe off your feet. But my guess is because this has a laminated floor, in the early days of lamination, just the heavy foot traffic right here may have begun to break down the bead foam a little bit, so they reinforced it and put something over top of it. That is a positive sign to me. That tells me that when these folks recognized something that needed addressed, they addressed it. They didn't let it sit and rot. Now this was built back when Outback had that beautiful all white interior, and it really made it nicer, brighter, lighter in here, even without the lights on. It's pretty darn nice. We do have central air, we do have central heat, so your family's gonna stay pretty comfortable. And where it really, that white cabinetry makes a difference really is in the kitchen space. It just really opens it right up in here and gives you a nice, big, bright-looking kitchen. I love the purpose-built wastebasket space right there. A couple bigger drawers instead of three small ones. I could go either way. I think that's a 50-50 win on whether two or three is better. The fact is there's drawers instead of none. That's a benefit. Another neat thing, you notice how clean the cabinetry looks. And what I mean by that is you don't see all the hinges. It's got a nice hidden hinge set up on it. And this is really one of the first lightweights to really jump on that bandwagon. That's something Outback did for a long, long time. Sofa can jackknife down into a sleep. Hold on, hold on. No, that is a full hide-a-bed. Took me a second to look at it. It's an old classic hide-a-bed. The dinette over here can fold down into a sleeping space. We've got easy access to the storage below it. This is either a nice pantry or linen space right here, and it's directly across from the bathroom, but still within reach of the kitchen, so it could kind of serve both purposes. Now, right here, I don't know if this is really translating well to camera, but they angled this wall back just to kind of open it up here a little bit, and it gives it a nice flow heading into the bathroom or the bunk space. You've got an easy foot flush stool here, so you don't have to have your face near your business. Extra countertop space on the side so that we have appliance room right there. We've got our blow dryers, our shavers can be hooked up, and that is a ground fault protected outlet, so you're not going to electrocute your family, which is obviously a positive thing. We've got a big medicine cabinet over here, so that we can actually keep all of our toothpaste and toothbrushes off of the nice countertop space we have, so we can actually use the countertop space. And this is, again, ahead of its time. A travel trailer with a fifth wheel shower. That is way ahead of its time, with extra linen space built right into the bathroom, which is something that a lot of trailers are only just now starting to do. They were doing 10, 11 years ago at Outback. So we've got a nice private rear quad bunk. There is room here, by the way. Like, if you look at us and go, ah, it's got that curtain. Whatever. You can put a door here. There's room. You could put a swing out door, and you could have a door here if you wanted one. It's not the end of the world. Don't let little things like that dissuade you guys. If you want a wall moved, we're looking at the wrong trailer. If you just want a fixture swapped out, no big deal. Give us a chance to do that, you know. Rear area back here, remember, we've got all that storage below. So it brings the bunks up to a nice, comfortable, easy climb-in level. You're not sleeping on the floor. Good storage here, again, for the kids, and a rear entertainment center for the kids as well. So on a rainy day, you've actually got some kids space back here. They put a vent on the ceiling to give kids some space there, as well as windows that do ventilate on all four bunks, which is a benefit too. As we're passing up through the front here, again, that nice light interior really opens it up. This was made before the day and age of flat screens just being the dominant force in RVs, so it does have a traditional entertainment center that's deeper. It also means that we get better storage in there, so that's not always a bad thing. Everything is a push and a pull. You know, nothing is just obviously the best. That's why manufacturers don't all build the same trailer, because there's different ideas for different people, and there's no one that is always the best in almost any case. Very standard front bedroom here, nothing to get too excited about. It does what it does. It does it well, though. But we do have a privacy door up here for mom and dad, so you know, you do have a private cutoff in this coach. All in all, not too bad, especially for an 06. Yes, the outside graphics, they've been cooked a little bit. But as far as I can see in the structure and the function of the RV, that is on point. And that's the most critical thing when you're looking at any used RV. So give us a call. 800-256-5196. Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Take care. Stay safe. Happy camping, everybody.